During the Kaikōura earthquake, there were over 20 major faults that ruptured and displaced the landscape in various ways. And here we are at the leader fault, and you can see 4 years later, the line of the uplifted fault line here, that's probably shot up about 3 meters. This is called the Wall of Waiau because it's such a spectacular feature. It's one of the most obvious fault ruptures in this particular area. In this photo here, which was taken by Kate Pedley from the University of Canterbury about a week after the earthquake, you can see how the fault line was really clean. It was a very clean vertical face. And now, 4 years later, you can see that vertical face has been eroded into a slope with a little bit of a bluff at the top of it. What's interesting also is a lake has developed because when one side moved up, it actually blocked the stream coming down this little valley. So it made a lake because the water couldn't get through because of the fault pushing the land up on one side. So just another incredible feature here in the landscape. It goes across the mountains, it goes into the distance in both directions. The whole landscape here was shaken, it was moved. So after that spectacular fault line, we are now in front of an enormous landslide. So all of that sunlit hill here used to be high up, and it all collapsed just after the earthquake. Dave and his wife Rebekah, who are the landowners here, described how about 45 seconds after the shaking started, they started to hear an incredible roar, and that was the landslide coming down from that triangular face and collapsing millions and millions of tons of rock and soil here. You can see that a lot of the trees are still growing. They were just sort of, the whole lot slope just went down in chunks, in big chunks. And also what happened is that the landslide dammed the river in the valley and created an enormous lake. And so now we can see here there's a waterfall coming down. The water has diverted sort of a little bit around the side of the landslide. But that lake has survived for 4 years, and it seems that it's stabilized, because sometimes these lakes, they kind of eat their way through the landslide, create a flash flood and disappear and become a bit of a hazard. But in this case, the lake is there, it's called Lake Rebekah, and the landslide has blocked the valley, blocked the river and diverted it now around in a new path following downstream and down the valley below. So an earthquake like the Kaikōura earthquake has reshaped the land. This landslide here really illustrates that, probably in the best possible way. It's one of the most mind-boggling things I think I've seen for a long time. So hope you enjoyed that. See you in the next one.